The Belize Blue Hole is one of the largest and most famous seaholes in the world. A seahole is a cave that was once flooded by rising waters and then collapsed on itself. Most of them appeared around 10,000 years ago, at the end of the last great ice age. You know it's simple to enter the Great Blue Hole, but only on the surface. The deeper you go, the more complicated it becomes. Going down to the very bottom requires exceptional diving skills, and only experienced divers are allowed to sneak a peek at the inside of the seahole. Unfortunately, scientists are sure that the Great Blue Hole is going to disappear at some point. Every day, new waterfalls of sand fall into it. This sand gradually fills the hole, and the process will go on until there's nothing left. But in 2012, this place was ranked number one on the list of the 10 most amazing places on Earth. That's why you decide not to waste any time. You set off on a journey to explore the very bottom of the mysterious Great Blue Hole. First, you travel by boat. Your destination is just off the coast of Belize. At one point, you notice an atoll. It's called Lighthouse Reef. It surrounds a large pool of dark blue water. It means you've reached your destination. The Great Blue Hole is about 1,000 feet across and more than 400 feet deep. Now, usually, people can withstand 3 to 4 atmospheres of pressure without experiencing any problems with health. It means that you can submerge to the depth of 130 to 140 feet and still feel okay. But the Great Blue is way deeper. That's why you've come prepared. A special bulky pressure suit will protect you from whatever you might encounter during your descent. Designed for very deep dives, it can allow you to reach the depth of 2,000 feet. Not that the Great Blue Hole is so deep, but you never know. As you begin your descent, you notice that the crystalline water around you, that seemed dark at first, starts getting clearer. It gives you an impressive view. It looks as if the Great Hole doesn't have a bottom. While slowly sinking under the weight of your pressure suit, you notice all kinds of marine life. Here is a massive grouper. And that creature? Isn't that the iconic hammerhead shark? Soon, you find there are lots of different shark species dwelling in the Great Blue. They're large Caribbean reef sharks, docile nurse sharks, smart and dangerous bull sharks. You can even spot some curious blacktip sharks. Luckily, they don't pay any attention to you. You also come across large turtles and beautiful giant corals. You pass by several ledges at a depth of 70 feet and 160 feet. There must be one more ledge at an impressive depth of 300 feet, but you haven't got so deep yet. The ledges confirm the hole's origin as an old limestone formation that appeared on land. After that, rises in sea level turn the place into a deep blue hole. The deeper you descend, the darker it becomes. Once you reach a depth of 50 feet, you notice the water shimmer. That's the invisible line dividing the sinkhole's salty top from the freshwater abyss. You notice a white layer of calcium carbonate at a depth of 290 feet. Once, there was a colossal coral reef there. It grew in the shallow, at that time, waters of the Caribbean. A bit deeper than that, at 300 feet underwater, you see something strange. But at that moment, you don't know yet how lethal your find is. This is a layer of hydrogen sulfide. It's spanning across the entire sinkhole like a thick floating blanket. The water around you and deeper becomes very dark. You can hardly see anything. But the worst thing? There's not a drop of oxygen here. On the surface, hydrogen sulfide is a colorless gas that smells like rotten eggs. It's flammable, corrosive, and toxic. No oxygen can get through its layer. Luckily, you don't need to worry about this. You brought your own, thanks to your suit. Suddenly, you spot something deeply unsettling. Hundreds and thousands of conch shells. Soon, you realize what happened here. Unsuspecting conchs were traveling too close to the edge of the Great Blue Hole. At some point, they lost their footing and fell into the abyss. They couldn't escape. The walls were too steep to climb. You can see tiny tracks leading back up the hill, then slide marks going back down. Unfortunately, no creature could survive down there without oxygen. You don't feel like lingering near the field of empty shells and go deeper. Soon, you see a berm of sand. A pointed ridgeline is running along the sides of the hole, but you're at a depth of 320 feet, and the Great Blue is 400 feet deep. You realize this 100-foot-tall berm has formed where sand pours into the blue hole from the edges far above. You also notice a trench. It stretches across most of the length of the sinkhole, but one of the hole's corners is already full of sand. It reaches the top of the berm. You dive into the trench and continue your descent. Finally, you reach the mark of 400 feet underwater. And that's when you see something exciting – small stalactites. They confirm the hole's ancient past. Stalactites can only form when water is dripping down the rock. This means that once, the Great Blue Hole was a large dry cave with various creatures living inside. Scientists analyzed the stalactites at the bottom of the sinkhole. They determined that these hanging structures got formed at different times – 153,000, 66,000, 60,000, and 15,000 years ago. You notice that some of the stalactites are tilted to one side. That means that there was not only a rise in sea level, but also a movement of the land. Finally, you touch the bottom of the Great Blue Hole. At the same moment, you feel your feet slip. You almost lose your balance. That's because the seabed is covered with a thick layer of silt. It's a record of hurricanes and storms, followed by long periods of droughts that happened in the past. You look around, and what you've been searching for is right in front of you. A series of caves filled with giant stalactites are barely visible in the murky waters near the bottom of the Blue Hole. These caves appeared hundreds of thousands of years ago. They were carved in solid rock by water filtering through them. This water also created huge columns of stalactites and stalagmites. In time, most of the caves collapsed in on one another, producing a 400-foot-deep abyss. Eventually, the warm Caribbean Ocean filled the chasm. It broke limestone and wiped out the caverns, but some of them still exist. You're ready to take your adventure to the next level and slowly swim into one of the caves. It's dark inside. You don't see any signs of life, only majestic stalactites and stalagmites surrounding you. Suddenly, a thought occurs to you. What if I find an entrance to an even deeper sinkhole in one of these caves? There's no scientific proof that such a passage might exist, but what if? Then you dive into this narrow opening. At a depth of 650 feet, you'd stop seeing anything around. That would be the beginning of the twilight zone. That's the depth very little sunlight can reach. The deeper you'd go, the darker it'd become. And if you got down to a depth of 3,000 feet, there would be no light from the surface whatsoever. Luckily, you'd have a flashlight attached to your suit. It'd be very quiet and spooky. You'd turn around and almost jump out of your skin. The creature would look like a squid, but it'd be huge. Its eyes would be the size of soccer balls. That would be a giant squid. It's a creature that looks like something from a horror movie rather than a real animal. While trying to get as far away from the monster as possible, you'd almost collide with something no less scary. The creature would be staring at you with barrel-shaped eyes. The thing that would unsettle you the most would be its transparent head. That's how you would encounter the barrel eye fish. You turn left and see something droopy and saggy floating near your elbow. The creature wouldn't seem to have a skeleton or any muscles. Its jelly-like flesh lets the animal survive incredible water pressure. Usually, the fish lies very still on the bottom, waiting for unsuspecting animals to swim by. You snap out of your thoughts, shudder, and decide you've had enough adventures for one day. You better leave exploring the caves to professionals. You push yourself off the bottom and start your way back to the surface.